It's Ali Drew for BBTV. Joining me now for the lockdown interviews is Huey Fury. Huey, how are you doing?
Yeah, I'm very good, thank you very much. How are you?
Yeah, I'm doing good, thank you. How is lockdown going?
Yeah, it's not going too bad, to be honest with you. Just obviously can go a bit insane. But I've been spending a lot of time with this one here.
Oh.
Even keeping me company. And that's it, really. Just been occupied with a bit of training. And listen, it's hard to keep eating healthy food as well, because otherwise you go fat as a pig. So I've been keeping myself occupied.
And are you training properly? Like, are you still sort of keeping that momentum, or are you just ticking over while until you can get back to the gym?
Yeah, I've still been doing plenty of training. I can't keep still on one of them. I always keep training and stuff, like been doing a lot of biking, rowing machines, stuff like that. And this week I'll be joining my dad and we're going to do a bit of a pad session and stuff like that, starting boxing training back up. So start hitting again, it's pretty good.
Is he keeping tabs on you, on the training and the eating?
No, not really. Don't really need to keep tabs on me. I'm quite disciplined myself, so I know what I've got to do to keep focused all the time. So it's quite easy for me.
Because you were out fighting just before lockdown happened, weren't you? A few weeks.
Yeah, I was very lucky, to be honest with you, to get a fight just before it happened, because it was just going along as it was just about my fight just got worse just after.
Well, it was a great performance that night. You came out and did a great performance, obviously stoppage. Did you plan for that to happen? Were you wanting a big result that fight?
Yeah, like you say, we've been working on a lot of different things inside the gym. And obviously, Andy was 10 times levels above my opponent. And it was just about just working on a few things. It was a bit of ring rust, but it just felt easy in there. And obviously, what we've been working on and stuff... off with the southpaw and mixing up. So, yeah, like you say, I'm looking forward to now just getting back in the mix and getting back out there as soon as possible.
What was the decision behind going southpaw?
I'm actually a natural left-hander.
Okay.
So I should have been... I got switched around when I was a kid, but everything seems to flow. Like you say, when I was always the orthodox, it was just that bit of a pause, but... with the southpaw, it seems to flow a lot more and I can let my shots go. And actually, the orthodox works right and works better. Now I'm switching both. It just seems more natural flowing. So, like I say, I've been working a lot on southpaw and just switching constantly. I obviously still keep me orthodox because I've been that way most of my life. So, yeah, but everything's good. It's like I'm a very awkward fighter, especially now in the different stance. So, it's just more tied to the arsenal.
And so you think you're going to keep that style, you know, switching between them? You think it obviously worked well for you?
Yeah, like you say, I feel comfortable that way and I'm powerful both hands. So it's, like you say, that's the way forward anyway.
Is it frustrating that you obviously had such, you know, a good fight beginning of March and then you're in good momentum and then suddenly get stopped during this, you know, for this lockdown? Is that frustrating?
Yeah, it's frustrating, but it's one of them. Nothing we can do about it. You can't moan. At the end of the day, there's a lot of people have been in problems. So, like you say, this is what it's meant to be. This is what you've got to do. But obviously, there's a lot of people been dying on the hill. So, if this is what stops that, then this is what we've got to do.
Well, when boxing actually gets back, what are you sort of wanting? What fights are you wanting to happen?
Like I say, I'm one of them. I've never ever been fussed who I fight or who I jump in the ring with. Doesn't bother me, but I'd like to be back out there and get back in the mix as soon as possible and just been working on what we've been working on, get these fights in and fight whoever.
Well, Eddie Hearn said after your fight that there's going to be a big one for you in the summer. Obviously, that's now going to be postponed a little bit, depending on when actually things get back to normal. But what kind of level, what fight was that he was talking about?
Listen, I wouldn't have a clue. Like I say, I'll leave it up to them. If they want to put me in the ring with whoever, put me in the ring. I've never been afraid to fight anyone. So, like I say, I'm more than ready and I'm more capable.
Top level, you're open to.
Yeah, 100%. I believe I belong there. And I've just come in short just by inches at the at top level. Like, I've only just let myself... It's not been the opponent beating me. It's been myself beating me, so... Like you say, I'm more than capable. Like you say, we've been adjusted a few things. I've been working hard. And now it's just ready it's just getting that perfect and then ready to step to that next level.
And are you keeping busy watching old boxing stuff on the on TV, or are you sort of having a break from boxing and just sorting your own training out?
Like I said, I just work on my own stuff, really, just the stuff we've been working out on, and just keeping fit, basically, mainly keeping your mind occupied, otherwise you'd go insane.
What are you doing to stay busy, to keep your mind going?
What am I doing? I'm doing quite a lot of things, to be honest. I've just started biking up. I've been doing the rowing machine. I'll show you my little setup.
Oh, yeah, show me.
So, this is me big, massive jacuzzi. Okay. But it's like a hydro pool as well, so you can do swimming as well.
Amazing. Have you been doing that? Obviously, nice weather.
I've been doing that as well.
Yeah.
So, also, we've been doing the rowing machine. This is my home little gym, by the way. Doing the rowing machine. We've got like a towel plate there. Got a few weights, exercises and stuff. So, yeah, we've got plenty to keep me occupied.
Are you going running with the dog?
Yeah, we go running with the dog. It's he's a bit of a lazy one, so we've got to take ease on it.
I can't go running with mine because he's like this big. No good.
Oh, yeah, little legs.
Yeah, he's sausage dog, so like his legs are like this long. Terrible.
Yeah, no, this one, he's too lazy and he likes to eat too much. He takes after me in that regard, though, 100%.
Yeah, isn't it hard, obviously, keeping with the diet, because you don't know when you're going to get back to actual proper training and when the fights are going to come. Is it hard to keep on track with the diet and to keep that motivation?
Yeah, because some days you don't feel like training. You feel like just going to a shop, buying loads of sweet stuff, getting on the bed, putting the Netflix or the Disney Plus on, yeah, and eating yourself to death. So it's hard. And also, the only thing I've got to what delivers to me is Domino's. So yeah, it's quite hard.
But are you doing it? Are you sort of balancing it?
Yeah, like I say, I'm quite disciplined. So I always eat healthy and I always just keep controlling. Really, it's like you say, I'm here. I do my own cooking, so we keep healthy food going.
So there's been talk that when boxing sort of gets going again, they're going to maybe start off doing it behind closed doors. Would you be up for doing that if that's the sort of the way to get it going again?
Yeah, what do you mean by closed doors?
As in, so basically no audience. It would just be the sort of the setup of the sort of the fighters and then the medics and the judges, but no actual crowd or anyone to come and see. They'd have to watch it, I presume, pay-per-view by the TV.
Yeah, that wouldn't bother me at all. At the end of the day, you're going for a fight anyway. So, like you say, you don't really think about the crowd when you're in there anyway. You just blank it out. So, yeah, like you say, that's quite interesting.
But yeah, it's an optimist talking about.
Listen, as long as there's two people in the ring, it doesn't really matter, does it?
Exactly. Yeah. You're up for just as soon as possible, just get it back on.
Yeah, as soon as possible, get back out there and get back to fight way. So I'm looking forward to it. How are you coping with lockdown?
Yeah, I'm not doing too bad, just staying busy. I've got a treadmill here and some weights, so I'm doing all that. And obviously I've got the sausage dog that's I'm going walking every day with him. He doesn't walk very far.
I bet you don't need to. I was about to say that. A few steps, it's done.
Yeah, it's not far. He gets tired. He's actually hating it. He hates going for walks. So he hates the fact that I'm taking him for like quite
the
long.
More, the more of a house dog, isn't he?
Yeah, he's more of a lap dog. He just sleeps, that's it.
Sleeps and eats.
But yeah, so we'll catch up. Obviously, when this all gets back to normal, we'll come and have a catch up. And then hopefully you can get a fight date lined up. And then we can do an interview and catch up with you then, if that's all right.
Yeah, no, definitely. You're always welcome to come down to the gym and stuff. And yeah, hopefully you survive sooner than later.
Have you been speaking to Savannah?
I stay in touch with her now and again. She's keeping good. I spoke to her the other day. I think she's carried on training now as well. So what about yourself? Have you spoke to her?
No, I haven't spoke to her. But I'm going to see if she will do an interview because it'll be interesting to catch her. I think she's gone back home for lockdown.
She's gone back home with the family. But she's taken along. So hopefully it was just a shame she got pulled into this just before her fight.
Yeah. Absolute nightmare timing for her.
It was, but I'd say she's good things will come to Savannah, for sure.
Yeah, it'll all come. Well, stay safe.
Yeah, you too, darling.
And we'll catch up soon.
100%.
Thanks for talking to us.
Take care.
Bye-bye. Bye.